Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. The Honorable Judge, I am Kevyansyah Putranwar. I am student of Lukman Al-Hakim Junior High School Surabaya. Today, I would like to deliver a speech with a title, The Impact of Technology on Teens Mental Wellness. Technology is rapidly evolving the regardless of how you feel about it. The changes are here to stay as a part of your daily life. According to 2018 Pew Research Center survey, 95% of teens now report they have a smartphone of access to one. This mobile connection connection are in turn fueling more present than on online activities. 45% of teens now say they are online on a near constant basis. Dr. Joshua Asri, to success, the effect that technology has on your youth during our weekly parents chat. As the director of outpatient clinical service at Clarity Child Guidance Center, Dr. Asri has significant insight into how technology impact your kids' mental wellness, identity, self-esteem, and body image. The use of social media can impact a teenager identity, self-esteem, and body image. It cannot be stated enough that people only show the best version of themselves on social media. Currently, expression who you are and how you feel might not create something post-worthy. Even mundane topics are given angle to highlight a point or the make joke. Even when you try to be authentic, social media cannot possibly fit the entire context of a situation. No matter your age, there is constant pressure for people to compare themselves to their peers. We ask question you like, who I am, how many followers do I have, how many likes did my last post get, how long are my snap still. Teenager especially feel pressure to portray themselves in a socially acceptable way to make people like them. Relationship development and attachment is now being met through a screen. Society is shifting more towards online engagement rather than in-person activity. During COVID-19, this has been an incredible boon, helping fight off isolation during a pandemic. FaceTime allow you used to speak face to face in real time with a relative halfway across the world. However, Dr. Asri say that he has had clinical experience where kids where parents living in another country start to identify their device their parents rather than understanding that their parents are speaking to them through the device. For good or bad, we are social creatures who require physical stimulation and social interaction. The lack of in-person connectivity leaves kids missing thus important component, lack of empathy. Another problem with technology is that design steals us people. Dr. Asri says that is pose a challenge for perspective talking as developing empathy for others. Studies show that 36.5% of kids feel like they have been cyberbullied in their lifetime. The price for making the derogatory comment to another person does not seem a step when is a talk a screen. Oftentimes, kids will not understand that there is a real person with real feeling behind that screen is that it is hard for them to understand magnitude a comment such and you're better off killing yourself during a gaming season. I am Kevin Saputra. Thank you very much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.